Wow, I have just finished watching AEW Wednesday Night Dynamite. I gotta say, for the first show, well done. What's going on, guys? It's me, it's Mr. PRIME, coming back at you guys with a review. That's actually the first time I'm coming at you with an AEW review. Wednesday Night Dynamite. Obviously, we know it's the head-to-head, the Wednesday Night Wars. But I decided to check out Dynamite first because I just really had an intrigue of what was going on. So, I'm going to give you my thoughts. We had Cody Rhodes, or Cody, versus Sammy Guevara. Now, coming into this, I thought Sammy was going to take the W, but then Cody said, if I lose against Sammy, then I don't deserve to be in the title picture. I was like, oh, well, I already know Sammy's not getting in the title picture anytime soon. Not this soon. So I was like, yeah, well, Cody's either winning or disqualification. But Cody won. During the match, I know Cody, Sammy Guevara pulled Cody into Brandy while he was diving. So that kind of, one of the things that happened on the match, but Cody won with a roll up. Honestly, didn't think he needed a roll up to beat Sammy Guevara, but I guess if they want to build up Sammy Guevara, this works. But I didn't think he needed a roll up to beat him. MJF versus Brandon Cutler. Honestly, I was doing some stuff during this match, so I didn't see the match, but I do know that. MJF won, of course, because he's better than you and you know it. One thing I probably didn't like is they had the Silent J, I mean Bob, Silent Bob and Jay. They were there and they were like promoting the movie. And then Helico and Jack Evans came up and then Private Party. I could have did without that segment, but it was nice seeing Chris Van Vliet. then we had. Let's see, I don't know if it was here or if it was after this match, but we had SCU in front of the White House, and Scorpio Sky has a nice Obama impression, but then they came out, and then they said it's going to be Bad Influence in the tag team tournament. Bad Influence, I'm glad it's Bad Influence, because I voted for Bad Influence on the little poll that they did, but then the Lucha Brothers come out, and then they get into a brawl, and then they go to the back, brawl to the back. OSW reference, if you know who those people are. We had Pac versus Hangman Adam Page. Good match back and forth. Very good. Like literally very, very good match. But in the end, Pac won. He did the Black Arrow to the back and then the I don't know what he calls it. The Brutalizer. Which is the Rings of Saturn. Pac, he keep getting this stuff up. He might I can see it being like Pac versus Cody for the title or something like that, But we have Riho versus Nyla Rose. I think for me this might be my match of the night. I'm not sure, but the drama and everything, this might be my match of the night. I don't know, but Riho versus Riho. Riho versus Nyla Rose was a very good match back and forth. It was like a David and Goliath match, but it wasn't typical David and Goliath story of, I'm big, so I'm about to just destroy you. It was back and forth. One point during the match, Riho jumped from the top rope, and Nyla Rose almost dropped her, but at the last second saved herself, so that was good. One point she got like a bunch of chairs and stacked them, and then lay Riho on the chairs, then jumped on the chairs, and then Riho moved, so she did a flip on the chairs on the stage. That was brutal spot. She tried to hit with an Alabama slam or something, but she dropped her. One point Riho was just standing on Nyla Rose's back, and Nyla Rose just stood up. Riho took a nasty bump there. What else? There's a lot of nasty bumps. Obviously, the knee from the Rio's hanging over the rope and the knee from the top rope for Nyla Rose. That looked brutal. She had a looked like a Northern Light suplex on the top rope, so that was nice. But in the end, Riho with the double knees got the win and is the new champion. Michael Nakazawa came out. Michael Nakazawa came out to interview Riho, and then this is, oh my god, Nyla Rose came out and attacks Riho and attacks Michael Nakazawa, puts him in the powerbomb, very close to breaking his neck, very if she would have went through with it, his neck would have been gone and probably would have been whew. But she saved herself and hit her with the powerbomb, and then she was about to attack Riho. Kenny Omega came out and was like, what are you doing? So I'm pretty sure after Full Gear, we're going to get Omega versus Nyla Rose somewhere in the future. We have Chris Jericho, Santana, and Ortiz versus the Young Bucks and Kenny Omega, a.k.a. The Elite. I like the Elite's gear here. It was very nice. So this match I honestly wouldn't say this is like a main event worthy match. It's just, this is like a filler main event match. Like, it's a good three good people that six good people that they know are gonna main event. So I thought this was gonna happen after the match, but they decided, nah, we're gonna do it during the match. During the match, Moxley comes in, attacks Omega. Not just attacks him, attacks Omega. And I know people will probably wonder, like, why is the referee not calling the bell? And I think it was the Road 2 where they kind of explained, like, referees have different personalities. So, like, well, one referee will probably disqualify you. One other referee will probably lay it back here, but I let it happen and see where it goes. Or, you know, so it kind of like the referee's discretion. Anyways, they go to the back, to the VIP area. This man hit a paradigm shift on a glass table. After that point, I was like, oh, this is real. they really want to do this feud. So Kenny, Omega, and Moxley gonna fight at Full Gear, but that's gonna have to be a street fight. Like, last time it wasn't scheduled to be a street fight, it's gonna have to be a street fight this time. Have to be. And Santana Ortiz and Jericho hit him with the Judas effect, and that's it. They get the win. After the match, they beat him up some more. They beat up the Young Bucks, and then Cody comes out fiery. Then Sammy Guevara comes out. He low blows Cody. Then they jump him. Then Dustin comes out. And then I've been hearing rumors about this. I was like, oh, they probably don't want him. Jake Hager, a.k.a. Jack Swagger, the All-American, comes out. And they just wreck shop. Hit him with a gut-wrench powerbomb. Hit him with a lot of Swagger bombs. Jake Hager is... So I don't know if this is a faction that they're trying to start, or is this just heels being on top. But whatever it is, if they want to do a 5-on-5 next week, I don't know. If they want to do a 4-on-4, like Santana Ortiz, Guevara, and Hager versus the Young Bucks and the Rose Brothers, or something like that, then I feel like they're going with. Overall, nice show to start your debut. If you guys want me to still do AEW reviews, let me know. Or I could do Wednesday Night Wars, but everybody's doing that, so I might not. But, thanks for watching. Let me know what you guys think. Primetime is all the time, and we're out.
Come on, push the button!
Yeah, come on, push the button!
Push the goddamn button!
Push the goddamn button!
You heard what she said.